You know, 20 years ago, I came to this meeting. I said, I'll come. We can walk on the moon and we cannot repair cartilage. I said, you know, we need to focus on this. We need to really develop approaches for that. 20 years later, we don't know how to repair cartilage. And it's a very interesting tissue because cartilage is not an easy thing to repair. But how close are we? I think now we are developing drugs that will delay osteoarthritis. So the goal is, you know, you're gonna have osteoarthritis, cartilage damage. I'm not gonna repair it, but I'm gonna delay the joint replacement. I'm gonna reduce your pain. I'm gonna probably, you know, improve cartilage, you know, to prevent, you know, further destruction, but I'm not gonna be able to replace what you're born with. We have a lot of different meetings. I go to gene therapy meeting or stem cells meeting, but this one here is very unique because I have a lot of collaborators. And we used to have all the surgeons also with us here because the American Academy of Orthopaedic Surgery and the Orthopaedic Research Society used to be combined. But I think this is the main meeting for us. I mean, you know, all my best friends in science, the muscle expert, the bone expert, the cartilage expert, the tendon expert, all come together here. And I always like to come to this meeting. But I think it's really, we change our mindset because when we're a scientist, sometimes we think that, hey, we're going for the home run. We're going for the curing the disease. But at the end of the day, I think what we can do now is, if I take someone at 50 years of age who has osteoarthritis, and if I treat them with the drug we're developing now, and instead of having a joint replacement at 50, he got his first joint replacement at 60, it's a big deal. Because that's maybe the only joint replacement he's gonna have in his life.